Hello. It's me. Sunday night. And I haven't done a video in a little while, so I figured I'd put something up. So everybody knows my husband wants to do a video with him involved. As I told you before, he really is convinced he's gonna win some type of award or be famous or I don't fucking know. This guy's he's something special. Okay, so today what I am doing is I am going to do a spine 3. So I'm using the Nano, but you know, for those of you who are actually just starting, you probably don't even know or have not heard of different spine types or what they are. You've heard of them and you're not familiar with what they are. So there are tons of different spines because everybody's hair grows in different ways. So with feet and our points, we obviously have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, so a spine 5 is gonna end at point 5. A spine 3 will go to the tail. A spine 6 is going to go to here, which this is pretty much your standard right here for your practice and everything. There's also upper spine, which I'm gonna do maybe tomorrow, maybe the next day, I don't know. And there's also innate brows, which those I haven't even tried yet. And those are the ones that are like all spine and they go right through the middle. So there's not really like head strokes. They just go in. I think I got them all, did I? Yeah, spine 5, spine 6, spine 3, upper spine, and innate brows. I think that's about right. I mean, you could always have somebody who has no eyebrow hair and you just create it, but okay, and also I want to say that I am using my new little camera stand, so let's see how it works. My sheet is actually a little floppy because I have stuff done on the other side, so what's good about this, when you have latex that's kind of warped like this because you've been working on the other side, it kind of allows you to pretend to stretch the skin how you would. Just a little note. But I'm not gonna do that because then I would totally take away from the camera because I would need to be like this and all up in there. Actually, I probably could. Oh no. I'm just gonna do it here. So this one we're doing is spine 3, which like I said is gonna go all the way to the tail. This is personally my favorite. Obviously your you know, spine 6 is something that I just sit around and stick around with all day, but when it comes to the actual act and like what I like on people, I really love spine 3. That's pretty much my favorite. So I'm just trying to place this in a good spot. Like I said, this is my new guy, so we're not exactly best friends yet, but we'll get there. But it's way better than having my huge ring light in front of my face where I have to be like 2 feet away from my latex. Okay, so I am gonna do like just not full on stretching, but I'm just gonna flatten it because like you can see, I don't know if you can actually see that it's pretty warped. But like I said, this is actually kind of good practice for stretching skin and occupying one of your hands, or both of your hands, I should say. So I'm just gonna start with that bottom. I have to tell you, so my kids did, you know, little mini pumpkins, right? For Halloween. and they were sitting on our kitchen table, which is where I come to do this. So my husband was in charge of watching the kids yesterday, because I actually went out for once, and I'm sitting here at the table earlier, and I was doing a video, and I decided to not put that on because my husband was sitting in the background screaming about football. Anyways, long story short, somebody knocked over the pumpkin and the whole table smells like mildew and just gross. So it's kind of distracting. Okay, so on a spine six, this is where we would be bringing everything down, and then we'd have that, you know, that extra stroke that seems to mess everybody up. But on a spine three, we're going to keep doing lower strokes till we get to the end. So you're not really going to have that that rando stroke that goes right there. Remember, always twist with your fingers, not with your whole wrist. I'm just gonna turn this baby just a bit. Alexa next. I'll tell you, if you guys don't have an Alexa in your life, that is something to invest in. I'm pretty sure I've said that plenty of times. She's like my best friend. Because she just listens to me and doesn't argue, you know? So that's nice. It's like I'm trying to figure out how to place my hands without being in the way. Or my face, for that matter. Really hard getting my kids to sleep on the weekends or on Sundays because, you know, clearly they got to sleep in. Oh, my son's listening to me right there. I walked down the stairs. Okay, no. Jack? What do you need to grab, dude? It's 10:40. Okay, good. Alexa, next. Alexa, next. And then with the time change, too, that's fucked him up. So that's nice. Go back and do our filling. Alexa, next. Yeah, so ever since my husband was in my last epic video of him urinating in the middle of it, and you guys getting a kick out of it, he's like, oh my god, we gotta do it again. They love me. I'm like, oh my god, this guy. So this is where it becomes just a little challenging, is because right here you're used to just cutting it off, right? So this requires a lot more twist. To stay on the spine line, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. always remember, let's keep our blade as clean as possible. On latex and on live skin, anything. Now what kind of makes this one a little different is, so we would make a lot of stacks that would come, you know, more down and then at the tail pull out, but this is kind of all I don't want to say like tail strokes, but kind of similar, because you're not making those stacks that go. All the way to the end, or the bottom, I should say. Then once you get to point two, now we're gonna start pulling these a little longer. Remember, stay on the spine line, always. Strokes up there. I have to say, more often than not, my transition area is my problem area. I just don't, I don't know. It does not always do what I like it to do. So, what are we gonna do in this case? We're gonna shade. Okay, so here's your idea of a spine three, which is spine three is gonna go all the way to the tail. On live skin, it is personally my favorite. I really, really like the way it looks. I think it's really pretty. So give me 1 second, I'm actually gonna mix my shading. I'm gonna be using, so right there I used Arabian for my strokes, but what I am really starting to love is shading with Tina Davies, okay? We love Fee, I love Fee, I love a lot of Fee's things, I love their pigments, everything. Now, what I will tell you is Tina Davies pigments are super rich. I mean, they are so frigging rich. It's actually pretty incredible. I almost want to give you like an example so we could, yeah, let's do that real quick. Give me a second. I'm coming. busting out real quick. I'm going to bust out some pretty light latex in comparison to the feet. You can see the different color here. It's a little more white, so it'll give us a good idea of our colors here. Okay, so in the Tina Davies kit, it comes with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 colors and a shading fluid, or solution, I should say. And it's pretty cool. It thins it out even more for your shading, which is really awesome. But the colors. So I want to talk just briefly about these colors and why I like them. Like I said, super, super rich. So we'll start with Zero Ash Brown. I haven't even opened this one, I don't think, yet. I think that... yeah, I haven't opened it. These colors are just different, you know? I mean, there's no... It's kind of like dummy-proof, I mean, in a way. Okay, so... this is ash brown. This is technically the lightest color. This is the number 0. Number 0. Number 1. This one's really cool. This is gray, which I think is awesome. Make sure with the Tina Davies, if you do buy it, when you close it, you wipe off the top, because it does dry really, really fast. Number 2 is blonde, which I actually, again, have not used it. Let me shake that up. And if you can hear, it's almost like nail polish. There's a ball in there, which is really nice. So you really, really know you're getting it. Don't worry, I'm gonna smear these around in a minute. Maybe a micro brush or something. Number 3, medium brown. Number 4, bold brown. I'm sorry, that's number 5. Where's number 4? Number 4 is dark brown. I apologize. Just always give it a little shake. I'll drop so you guys can see. Again, always wipe off that top, just the tip. Sorry, can't you? Okay, number 5 is bold brown. Number 6 is ebony, but I already have an open one, which I won't use because I use that one for practice. Don't. Okay, so. So this one here was ash brown. As you can see, it's already like drying. There's like barely any gloss to it. This one was gray. Okay. The next one was blonde. Which that one's really pretty. Three is medium brown. Four, dark brown. Five, bold brown. And then number six is ebony. So I hope you can see the difference in the colors here. The good thing about it too, guys, is guess what? There's no rules with mixing pigment, okay? So you can use your Fee pigment that you love, your go-to, whatever, and then you can be like, you know what? I really like B2, but I want to add a little bit of, you know, let's just say it's medium brown to my pigment. And it gives it, like, it's so rich. I can't, you know what, let's do a little, I'll show you. So, I will take just a little bit from here. This is ebony. So I've been using Arabian, right? I use Arabian basically for everything. So now the thing about this is it gets on there. And what Tina Davies instructs you to do with her pigments is you're supposed, this is the rule. So you're supposed